Hello students, welcome to the next session. In this session I am going to discuss the next chapter, which is the 7th chapter, where I will be explaining about what is interfacing and what are the applications. Now, coming for this chapter, in this chapter I am going to explain few topics. Like, let me start with the topic which is like MDI. As the name says, MDI stands for Multiple Document Interface. Multiple document interface in the sense, in a single application, you will be able to open multiple files. Suppose say, you are using a software called as TurboC. So, I am taking this example because you already used this particular application. If you are using TurboC, TurboC is an application software where you will be executing your C program. So, this software will be supporting multiple files, that is to say, you can, if you have two or three programs, program 1, program 2, program 3, all the three programs can be opened at a time, and you can select any one program for your that is a processing, that is to say, you are opening multiple files, that is multiple documents. Program 1 is a document, program 2 is a document, so that does nothing but you are opening multiple files, which is to say, it will be acting as multiple document interface. Now, what are the advantages of multiple document interface? So, there are several advantages. So, like say for example, if you have, first I will just explain what is the use of RAM here. Now, RAM, as you know, it is random access memory, or it is also called as primary memory. Now, why you are using RAM is, since your central processing unit, that is CPU, can access the information or the data that is present in RAM easily. So, if you are storing some information on your hard disk, suppose say I have a SSD or any kind of hard disk, SSD or hard disk drive, if you have these hard disk drives information. Now, I have a software called as TurboC. If I have the TurboC software in hard disk, if I want to execute that particular TurboC software, that software first it should be loaded onto the RAM. So, once it is loaded onto the RAM, that will be used by CPU for executing that particular software. Now, so if this is the case, now if I am using multiple document interface, what happens is, if say suppose TurboC software is of 10 MB, or I'll use 10 MB of memory space will be used in RAM for TurboC. I'll open three files. If I open three files, all those files will be of say 2 MB. Three files will be of 2 MB. So total it is occupying how many MBs? It is totally occupying around 12 MB of space. Now, that is to say, in 12 MB of space, I can open two or three documents. The same thing if I am using, suppose say, your Microsoft Word. If I am using Microsoft Word, it will be acting as single document interface. When I say single document interface, that is to say, you are opening only one file, one document in that particular application. That is to say, if you have document 1, suppose say I have file 1.doc, and again I will have file 2.doc. If you try to open these two files, that is file 1.doc as well as file 2.doc, it will open in two different interfaces. File 1 will be having separate interface, file 2 will be having separate interface. That is to say, it will be acting as single document interface. That means to say, file 1 will be allocated memory separately and file 2 will be allocated memory separately. So, this leads to memory inefficiency, because it needs multiple times, it needs to select file 1, file 2. If you are selecting file 1, again you will go to file 2. It is nothing but we are switching from one file to other file. There, the memory efficiency will be less. So, that is to say, whenever you are using MDI, it will increase the memory efficiency. Efficiency of the memory will be increased if you are using MDI. And second important feature when you are using MDI is, when you are using MDI, you can share the information. Like say, you have a common menu. In the sense, TurboC, if you see, you have a common menu that will be used by all the documents. If you consider file 1, that is say file 1, file 2, you will have separate interface itself where it will have separate menu again. Okay. Now, so that is say if you have MDA form, we can share the resources between all the different kind of applications. And so when you are using MDI, it will be easy to work with, like say, multiple files at the same time. You can open multiple files and you can execute or you can edit that multiple files at the same time if you are using MDI based applications. If you are using single document based application, that is not possible. So those are some of the advantages that is related to multiple document interface. Not only this, you will have other advantages, like say multiple document interface can share other informations, like say if you have some information in one program and if you want to copy that to other program, all those things can be that is possible if you are using multiple document interface. So other than this, whenever I say multiple document interface, multiple document interface will also support some other features. Say for example, if you have a multiple document interface, I'll have the application. That application will have a child frame. So that child frame is where you're going to see all your documents. Example, you can consider your Visual Studio software itself. When you consider your Visual Studio software, you'll have a software here. You have opened the project one. If you have form 1, form 2, form 3, if you have 2 or 3 forms, all those forms will be displayed in the child frame itself. Okay, so that is nothing but your Visual Studio will be also acting as what? Multiple document interface. Okay, so whenever this is happening, you can select which form you want, you can maximize that and you can work on it, or you can see multiple files at the same time. For example, how that is done? In this MDI form, suppose say if you are using any MDI application, there will be a menu called as window. Under that window menu, you have the features like cascade, tail, as well as so list of files. So cascade is when you have 2 or 3 forms or documents, if those documents are opened and those documents are overlapped between one another. Suppose say form 1 will be there, behind that you will have form 2, behind that you will have form 3. That kind of view is called as cascade view. So that is where we are going to see the multiple documents one behind the other. So that type of view is called as cascade view. If I consider tail view, so where you will have, if I have opened 2 forms, form 1, form 2, I need to see at the same time. In that case, I'll be using tail view, where all the document that is present in the MDA application will be seen at the same time. So that can be done horizontally or that can also be done vertically. Again, suppose if you have minimized any particular form and if you are not able to see that particular form, so that form will also be listed under the menu called as window menu. So this is about the features or advantages of your multiple document interface. Hope this is clear. So next session I'll discuss one more topic, which is splitter window. Hello students, I'll continue in the same session with the one more topic called as splitter window, which is splitter window. Now whenever I say splitter window, splitter window, as the name says, we are going to split the window. That is to say, whenever you have any particular application, you have an application, that particular application, if you want to divide that into 2 or 3 sections, so example, you can consider some softwares like your Paint. If I consider Paint, when you open that particular Paint software, by default, you are going to see that it will be divided into 2 sections, where one section you are going to have the tools and second section you are going to have the blank white screen where you are going to do all your editing, right? So that is, we are going to split the window. Paint is a basic window. That window will be split into 2 sections, where it will have one section for tools and other section for that is to say for editing. So this is called as splitting window or splitter window. How this is done? So this is done by using
inbuilt class called as CSplitter window. We have an inbuilt class called as CSplitter window. Now, as we discussed in our previous sessions, where we'll be using like C frame window or C win app. So these classes are predefined classes that will be used for creating an application and creating a frame. Now, coming for this particular class, will be used for dividing a single window into sub windows. Now, coming for the types of the splitter window will be divided into majorly two types. One is like static, other one is like dynamic. We have two different types of splitter windows. One is static splitter window, other one is dynamic splitter window. While coming for static splitter window, static splitter window is this is created when the application is started, or we have a concept called as instantiation. Now, if you remember your C++ concept, in C++ concept we have a concept called as instantiation. What is instantiation? Instantiation is the process of creating an object. When the object is created, that process will consider it as instantiation. Now, when a process or whenever an application is created, we are going to create an object of that particular application that we have seen in our previous program, where we will be using CWin app. So by using that app, I am going to create a class, and if you want to create that particular application, we will be creating object of that application. Similarly, whenever you start executing any application, we are going to create object of that particular application. That is nothing but we are doing what? Instantiation. When instantiation is done, so at that time itself, if the window is splitting, that is done at the, if it is a static window. If it is a static splitter window, then when the application or the when the software is created or whenever it is started, at that time only we are going to divide the window into separate windows. That type of splitting is called as static splitter window. And whenever you have static splitter window, that particular window will be fixed. That is to say, you cannot change the content there, or you cannot move that particular window to some other place. That cannot be done if it is what type? If it is static splitter window. Example, you can consider status bar at the end of that particular application, or as I told you, tools menu. So our menu, those type of splitter window, you cannot change it. And again, if it is static splitter window, you can have multiple views. You can have multiple views. What I mean to say is multiple views. For example, when you start your MS Word, you're going to have like this. First, you have the title bar. Under that, you'll have menu here. So under that, you'll have the document here. This menu, you're going to change it to several things, like say file menu, edit menu, view menu, all those things you're going to change. Different menus can be changed here in this section, or in that particular splitter window, I can change that into multiple sections. So that is, you can view multiple information if it is static splitter window. Again, static splitter window, whenever you are using, you can have maximum of 16 rows and 16 columns. That is to say, a window can be divided into maximum 16 rows as well as 16 columns. So that is about what is static splitter window. Hope this is clear. Now we'll go to the next topic, which is dynamic splitter window. So dynamic splitter window, in this case, if you have the same particular application, so in that application you are going to see some splits that you can add whenever required and you can remove whenever it is not required. That is, user will have the permission to add that particular splitter window whenever it is required, and you can remove it whenever it is not required. Example, if you consider your Visual Studio itself, in the Visual Studio you will have a toolbar, you have a project menu, you have property window. Those windows can be removed, or it can be moved to any other place, and you can minimize it or you can close it, and whenever it is required you can go to a menu called as view menu. Under view menu you can select and you can display that particular toolbar or property window or project explorer. So that type of splitter window is called as dynamic splitter window. So dynamic splitter window, so it will be having only single view. So that is to say, it will have only single view. That is say, for example, project explorer, you can see only the information that is related to project only. You cannot see properties is there. So like that, we are going to divide, or we are going to have only single information in that particular window. Again, when you consider dynamic splitter window, you can have maximum of 2 rows and 2 columns. That is to say, a single window can be divided into maximum of 2 rows and 2 columns. Again, next, coming for the next major difference between dynamic splitter window and static splitter window is, dynamic splitter window will share, it will share scroll bar. That is to say, if I have a scroll bar, if I have two different windows, for the same two different windows, it will share the same scroll bar. That is not the case with static splitter window. In the case of static splitter window, if I have a scroll bar here and if I have a scroll bar here, this scroll bar will be separate for this splitter window and you'll have a separate scroll bar for this splitter window if that window is of type static splitter window. So this is about the concept which is static splitter window. Hope this is clear. Thank you. I'll continue in the next session with the other topic.